this 18 part, we shall start discussing the provisions regarding arrest of persons. Now, while starting with this particular chapter, let me point out that law relating to arrest in the past was inadequate as observed by the Supreme Court in n number of cases. And hence, Supreme Court in the year 1997 in D.K. Basu versus State of West Bengal had laid down 11 guidelines as far as arrest of an accused person is concerned. The Criminal Procedure Code is amended, and you must know the amended Criminal Procedure Code up to date. Hence, during course of lecture, when you deal with this chapter as far as arrest of persons is concerned, right from section 41 up to section 60A, capital A of the Criminal Procedure Code, you will come across many amendments as far as this chapter is concerned. For example, 41 capital A, 41 capital B, 41 capital C, 41 capital D, 50 capital A, 53 capital A, 54 capital A, 55 capital A, and then 60 capital A accordingly. This is enumerative. I hope you remember during the last lecture, I made it very clear that now once you start with the procedure, it is necessary for you to do some homework simultaneously at the time when you are listening to the lecture that is delivered by me. At least you have to keep a barrack with you for a ready reference, and then it is with the help of the barrack that it is possible for you to club the sections. It is possible for you, because when it's a question of enumeration, it may not be possible for me to make mention of each and every point, and hence I shall try my best, no doubt about it, but then this is the practice which is required to be followed by you. Now, the point I had drawn your attention to D.K. Basu versus State of West Bengal, which was decided by the Supreme Court in the year 1997, is for the simple reason 11 guidelines were laid down by the Supreme Court, some of which, because of the amendment, are incorporated as far as this particular chapter of the Criminal Procedure Code is concerned. But all 11 guidelines, for that you can have comparative study by going through the amendments and the 11 guidelines that were laid down by the Supreme Court. And it was made very clear by the Supreme Court as far as Article 141 of the Constitution of India is concerned, that had become law of the land and that will continue to be the law of the land unless it is struck down. Hence, the 11 guidelines when you read, and some of the guidelines today also which are not at all included as far as the amendment to the Criminal Procedure Code is concerned, is the law of the land of which you have to take note. And hence, in the absence of, when you are reading this particular chapter, in the absence of the importance of D.K. Basu versus State of West Bengal, the understanding of this particular topic is incomplete. What is the manner of arrest and amendment which is made as far as section 60 capital A is concerned, clearly lays down that arrest shall be made as per the provisions of the Criminal Procedure Code or any other law for the time being in force. So it is must, and it says arrest shall be made, it is mandatory, no discretion is given. The person making an arrest has to arrest a person as per the guidelines which are given or as per the provisions that are laid down as far as this chapter of the Criminal Procedure Code is concerned. Now, to understand this chapter, as it runs into many sections, I mean, try to classify this as I had told you last time. First of all, try to understand who can make an arrest. And to understand this, if you read subclause 1 of section 41, which is a question of enumeration, you start with small a up to small I, and as per if the case of an accused person falls under any one of the categories which are enumerated as far as subclause 1 of section 41 is concerned, then the police officer has got right to arrest a person without warrant. In this chapter, we are dealing with arrest without warrant. In the next chapter, when we will start right from section 61 up to section 90, namely the processes to compel appearance of a person in court of law, and when we will start right from section 70 up to 81 of the chapter, we will try to understand that there can be arrest with warrant also. So there can be arrest without warrant, and there can be arrest as per the warrant also. This is the chapter which is confined as far as arrest without warrant is concerned. So there can be arrest by a police officer without warrant as per subclause 1 of section 41 of the Criminal Procedure Code. Now, if you remember, when we were discussing fourth vertical column of the first schedule of the Criminal Procedure Code, in order to know the distinction between cognizable and non-cognizable offences, we have learned that if the nature of the offence is non-cognizable, police officer has got no right to arrest a person without warrant, to which section 42 of the Criminal Procedure Code is an exception. If somebody commits non-cognizable offence in presence of police officer, or if he is accused of commission of a non-cognizable offence, then the police officer is bound to ask his name and address, and if the person doesn't tell name or address, or the address or name which is told by him, if the police officer has got reason to believe to be false, in order to ascertain the true name and the address, the police officer has got right to arrest him, namely to detain him, as far as this particular section, namely section 42. So there can be arrest even though the person is accused of an offence of which nature is non-cognizable, as per the provisions which are laid down as far as section 42 is concerned. Section 43 makes mention as to when there can be arrest on the part of the private person. And then section 44 tells you when there can be arrest on the part of the magistrate, which is inclusive of judicial as well as executive magistrate. Arrest by a private person if the offence takes place in his presence of which nature is cognizable and non-bailable, in other words, in case of serious offences, private person has got right to arrest a person, he has got right to arrest him, and then he will hand him over to the officer, and then police officer will follow the procedure, namely, he will re-arrest him if his case falls under subclause 1 of section 41 of the Criminal Procedure Code. He has also got a private person has also got right to arrest who is known as a proclaimed offender. So if you read section 44, which makes mention, when offence has taken place irrespective of the nature of the offence in presence of a magistrate, maybe a judicial or executive magistrate within his jurisdiction, he has got right to arrest such a person. So, the first part, when you start discussing who has got right to arrest a person without warrant, you have to take into consideration arrest by a magistrate, arrest by a private person, and arrest by a police officer accordingly. Now, what is the procedure that is required to be followed as far as the arrest is concerned? And then, this is the time for us to understand as to what do you mean by arrest. Now, this has got reference to what? This has got reference to cross-reference to Article 21 of the Constitution of India, which says no person shall be deprived of his life or personal liberty except according to the procedure established by law. And hence, what is arrest? Arrest is an encroachment with respect to personal liberty guaranteed by Article 21 of the Constitution of India. So, what is arrest? It is a confinement. What is the nature of the confinement? It is a lawful confinement. Why it is a lawful confinement? Because it is not wrongful confinement. Even if there is a mistake of fact at the time of arresting a person, and if the police officer has acted in good faith, police officer is not liable. He is not liable for the offense of wrongful confinement because he is protected as far as section 76 of the Indian Penal Code is concerned. And I hope you remember, right from section 76 up to 106 of the Indian Penal Code are the general exceptions in which if the case falls under any one of the general exceptions, that will not amount to an offense as per the provisions of the Indian Penal Code. So what is arrest? It is confinement. It is apprehension. And what is the manner? And the in order to understand this, a person who wants to make an arrest, what he will do? He will actually touch or confine the body of the person unless there be a submission by word or action. So it's not at all necessary that the person is arrested only when he is handcuffed or rope is tied to his arm. Certainly not. When he is not allowed to go beyond a certain circumscribing limits, then he is under custody, he is under the control, he cannot move anywhere without the permission of the person who has arrested him. That is what is known as arrest as per section 46 is concerned. With this now, there may be any chance or possibility that the person to whom he is going to arrest, such a person may try to evade, or there may be efforts on his part to evade the provisions of the arrest. So what can be done by the person who wants to arrest him? He can resort to all means, as a result of which he will see that the person is arrested accordingly. Now with this now, so he can resort to all means for the purpose of effective arrest. He is laid down as far as subclause 2 of section 46 is concerned. Section 46 subclause 3 makes mention as to what is the maximum force that can be used for the purpose of effective arrest. And then, if the person is accused of an offence which is punishable with death or life imprisonment, the right of the person arresting him extends to the causing of his death also. But this is as per what? As per subclause 3 of section 46. What to do with respect to arrest of a woman? And then we have subclause 4, as far as arrest of a woman is concerned, she cannot, unless there are exceptional circumstances, there cannot be arrest of a woman after sunset before sun rises, as per the provisions and the details are mentioned as far as subclause 4 is concerned. This section 46 is to be read along with section 41 capital B of the Criminal Procedure Code, so you come to know the procedure in detail regarding arrest. And there you say, a person who is carrying out arrest when he is a police officer, he must display his accurate designation, accurate name, accordingly it must be properly displayed at the time of the arrest. He will also make arrest memo, which is required to be attested by a witness who must be his from family, or if not, he must be a respectable member from that particular locality. Well, if you read capital C as far as subclause 41 is concerned, when the person is arrested, information is required to be displayed at the control room, so that it is possible for everybody to know when he was arrested and where he was kept accordingly, are the details which are mentioned as far as these provisions are concerned. There can be arrest of a person anywhere within the territory of India. But when the police officer wants to arrest a person and he enters, he goes to the place where he wants to enter, and if the person is in the house, in that case, He has got right of forcible entry by breaking open the window or the door. That is made very clear as far as section 47 of the Criminal Procedure Code is concerned. So as I mean procedure, you go on I mean clubbing the sections by merely reading the heading of the section, it becomes very easy for you to understand as to what is the procedure that is required to be followed as far as the arrest of the person is concerned. With this now, the next part, this is procedure as far as arrest of a person is concerned, procedure that is required to be followed as far as arrest of a person is concerned. Now, the next time, this is the time for us to understand as to what are the steps that are taken or what are the rights of the person who is arrested by the police and rest of the provisions with which we will continue our discussion as far as next part of our series of lectures is concerned.